Hello everyone, myself Amrit Kumar Singh and I'm teaching you heat and mass transfer for your GATE examination. So my dear students, let us see that how heat transfer is occurring inside the internal pipes, okay, when there is an internal flow. My dear students, what will happen, let us see. So let us see, there is a pipe. Let us see, there is a tube or pipe, my dear students, and this pipe is having some surface temperature TS. This pipe is having some surface temperature TS. Okay. Okay. Now, if I want to calculate the heat transfer, if this is having some surface temperature, my dear students, if this is having some surface temperature, let us take the surface temperature is TS and the fluid temperature is T infinite. The fluid temperature is T infinite. So I have taken this TS and the fluid temperature to be T infinite. Okay. Now, what will happen? As soon as the fluid will enter inside this, let us say at the inlet of the pipe, let us take that is your inlet, that is x in this direction and that is the length of the pipe and that is, let us say, exit, temperature of the exit. So fluid will enter inside the pipe and fluid will go out. So let us take m dot 2 out and let us take m dot 1 in inlet. Okay. As the fluid entered, let us take this fluid is cold. Okay. Now, as this fluid entered inside this, my dear students, and as soon as it entered like this region, what will happen? Slowly, the heat will be transferred from this pipe to this fluid, my dear students. Heat will be transferred to this. So, as the heat will be transferred, what will happen? The temperature of the fluid, let us say it is entering at 20 degrees Celsius and plate is at 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, there is this much difference, my dear students. So what will happen? As this fluid will enter inside this, what will happen? There is 80 degree temperature difference, but after some time, maybe the fluid is having like 30 degrees Celsius temperature. Then what is happening? Then this is like, let us say 100 degrees Celsius, or let us say continuous heating is there, or TS can also change. So what will happen? That temperature of fluid will change. Yes sir, because it is continuously gaining heat, so that's why the temperature of the fluid will change. Okay. Now, so if I will talk about the mean temperature, let us say mean temperature is 30 degrees Celsius here. So what will be the heat transfer? So heat transfer will be given by nothing but HA and dT by dx, or sorry, HA into TS minus, it must be T inlet. So if I will see the heat transfer at the inlet, my dear students, if temperature will not change, what will be the heat transfer? This will be TS minus TI. If I will see the heat transfer at the exit, what will be the heat transfer? HA, TS minus TE. Yes or no? TS minus TE. But what is happening, sir, that TI is changing, or TE is like, these both are fixed, but in the middle of this, all this, that temperature is changing. So the fluid temperature is changing. And as the fluid temperature is changing, my dear students, so what we have defined? We have defined a mean temperature. So what I will say, that Tm, that is mean temperature, we have defined a mean temperature, that Tm will be equal to Ti at the inlet, and Tm will be equal to T exit, Te at the outlet, and that Tm will be varying from inlet to the outlet, my dear students, inlet to the outlet. Now let us say, this Tm is varying. So if I will give heat continuously to this, my dear students, so what will happen? The surface temperature of this will also change? Yes or no? If I will provide heat continuously, let us say I am giving 10 watt per like 10 watt continuously, 10 watt, again 10 watt, again 10 watt, again 10 watt, again 10 watt. Like per unit length, I am giving 10 watt per meter, 10 watt per meter, or length of the pipe I am giving. So what is happening? So the surface temperature is also changing. So TM is also changing. That is mean temperature changing. And TS, that is surface temperature is changing. So both are changing, my dear students. So how we can calculate? How we can calculate the heat transfer? Okay, when both the temperatures, the surface and this is changing, and also we can see the heat transfer is also changing, so we cannot calculate the heat transfer in this case. So what should we do? So there can be like one procedure when I will take the heat flux, my dear students. So if I will take heat per unit area, that is Q divided by area, that is nothing but your heat flux, my dear students, which is equal to H into TS minus T infinite or TS minus TM, my dear students. So what will happen? So at per unit area, although the heat will change, but what I am taking is that there is constant heat transferred through this per unit length as I have taken. And as there will be the constant heat transfer, what will happen? That TS will change and TM will change, but as there will be constant heat transfer, only TM will vary as the TS will vary, or we can say that H is constant in this case, this is constant now, and this is also constant, my dear students. So what will happen? Only TS minus TM will be constant. As TM will vary, TS will vary. So I can easily develop an equation for this case. And there can be another case. What? There can be another case. What? When heat transfer is changing, let us take. When heat flux is changing, let us say Q is changing. Small Q is changing. That is nothing but TH into TS minus TM. So when this will change, so what I will do? I will keep the TS constant. And what will happen in this case? That TM will vary. So as Q heat transfer will increase, then mean temperature will also increase. If Q will decrease, then heat transfer will also mean temperature will also decrease, my dear students. So there can be only two cases, or this will be where TS will be constant for your phase change, my dear students. So there can be only two cases, like when surface temperature is constant and when your heat flux is constant. Let us study the first case when heat flux is constant first. Okay, let us study the first case. So we can also note here, as heat is transferred to the fluid. So what I have told you, I am just writing, heat is transferred to the fluid. Mean temperature will increase will increase if reading is there, will increase or decrease, and also surface temperature will increase. So as heat transfer is equal to H into ATS minus TM, my dear students. So as heat transfer coefficient is constant. So we can take Ts minus Tm is constant, and that will be our first case, my dear students, when we will assume what? Constant heat flux. So let us see the first case, my dear students. So in first case, what will happen? I will take that heat flux is constant, my dear students. So let us take the case first. Let us study it carefully so that all the concepts will be built again. Okay, my dear students, let us see. So case first will be your constant heat flux, that is Q is equal to constant. Okay, now, so where this will happen, let us see. So let us say example. For example, if an electrical wire is wound on pipe, then there will be continuous heat flux like that. So let us say if pipe is there and you are wrapping a wire over this, so that there will be continuous heat transfer. So like this, you are wrapping a wire. What will happen? So there will be continuous heat flux. So there will be continuous heat flux to this permanent area. The heat transfer will be same in all directions, my dear students, in all directions. Or you can also take the another example, that is your a pipe exposed to radiation, my dear students. Radiation. So what will happen? So the pipe is there and fluid is flowing inside this. Okay, then there will be radiation, there will be continuous heat flux in all directions, my dear student. That is Q is constant. So let us see. So if heat transfer will be constant, and if I will analyze a pipe, what will happen? Let us see. So let us say this is your pipe, my dear students. Okay, and let us take it down. So let us take, this is your pipe. So this is your inlet. Let us take that is your TI, my dear students. That is your exit. Let us take it TE, my dear students. Okay. Now, as soon as the fluid will come inside the pipe and will flow inside the pipe, what will happen? Let us see. So now this fluid, that pipe is exposed towards some constant heat flux. So there will be constant heat flux. Okay. So there will be constant heat flux, my dear students. That is Qx is, let us take Qx is equal to constant. Why I am taking x? So because in this direction there is a length of the pipe, and what will happen, let us see it carefully. So as soon as the fluid will enter inside this, my dear students, what will happen? The fluid will start gaining heat. And due to which the temperature of the fluid will increase. So at Ti will be there, Ti, no problem. So slowly the temperature of the fluid will increase. That means the mean temperature will increase, my dear students. Okay. So let us consider at a distance x, my dear students, the temperature is Tm. So can we say that heat flux is nothing but equal to how much? Let us see. So heat flux is given by that is Q is equal to, if you have not felt, let us wait, I will just explain it. So H is nothing but equal to delta T. So that Q is X, let us take it Q double dot. So this will become H into T surface, because what will happen? How heat will be transferred? Let us see. So if Ti is the inlet temperature of the fluid, Ti is the inlet temperature of the fluid, what will happen? So this will gain heat because there is some surface temperature, you are continuously supplying heat to the fluid, What will happen? Internal energy of the fluid will increase. My dear students. So what has happened? So Ts, if Ts is the surface temperature at this moment, and Ti, which is nothing but we are taking Tm as the surface temperature, that will have Ts minus Ti, some heat transfer will be there. Okay. Similarly, at the exit, we are supplying 10 watt per meter. 10 watt per meter or per unit area. 10 watt per meter square we are supplying. So 10 watt per meter square I have given to this. So what is happening? The surface temperature is increasing. So the surface temperature will increase. Similarly, then I will give 10 watt per meter square. Then surface temperature will increase. So along the x or area, which is given by pi dx, my dear students, pi dx, as x increases, area increases, and as area increases, the heat transfer is also increases. That is equal to q into a into qx. So as area increases, the heat transfer also increases, and due to this increase of heat transfer, the surface temperature of the wall of that cylinder will also increase. Yes, sir. The surface temperature of that wall is increasing. Yes, let us see. So the surface temperature of that wall is increasing. So that is your Ts, my dear students. So from inlet to exit, the surface temperature is increasing. Are you feeling that concept now? From inlet to exit, the surface temperature is increasing. Why? We are giving continuous heat to this. That's why the surface temperature is increasing. So as the surface temperature is increasing, what will happen? I am also giving heat to the fluid. Why? How am I giving heat to the fluid? So let us take it. This will be nothing but let us take it later on. So what will be the heat gained by the fluid? So heat gained by fluid will be equal to nothing but what? That is nothing but mass of the fluid. Mass of the fluid multiplied by Cp of the fluid. That is absorbing capacity of the fluid multiplied by surface temperature. And first of all, I will take inlet temperature, but then it will become T min. So Ts minus Tm, my dear students. Ts minus Tm in this case. So let us say the surface temperature must be Tm minus Ti. Why? Because at inlet the fluid will enter from here and then it will become Tm. So there will be some this. So Tm minus Ti will be the surface temperature of what? Will be the temperature difference for the fluid. And as Tm will increase from inlet, so as Tm will be increasing continuously and it will be giving heat continuously, by the instrument. So similarly, here also, what will be the heat flux? So heat flux will be nothing but Ts minus Tm, my dear students. So now we know that Tm is increasing. Let us take it equation number 2. And that is nothing but what? Heat gained by the fluid, Q total. So from inlet to outlet, the mean temperature is also increasing. That is your Tm, my dear students. So from Ti to Te, your mean temperature is also increasing. So what I am considering is, I am considering a temperature Tm at a distance x. At a distance x, my dear students. So let us consider temperature Tm, or mean temperature at distance x is Tm. Mean temperature at distance x is Tm, my dear students. So then what will be the heat transfer, my dear students? What will be the heat transfer in this case? So heat transfer in this case will be equal to how much? Let us see. So at a distance x, the heat transfer will be equal to, given by q is equal to same, that is h multiplied by area. What will be the area for this? This is the circular pipe having some diameter d. This is the circular pipe, my dear students, having some diameter d. Yes. So the area will be nothing but equal to how much? This will be pi dx. Because up to x I have taken. So up to x, the fluid will gain the heat from Tm minus Ti. So this will be Ha, which is nothing but D into x into Ts minus T infinity, Tm, my dear students. And we know in this case Ts minus Tm will be constant because heat flux is constant and Q is constant and H is constant. So Ts minus Tm will be constant throughout, my dear students. So the difference will be constant throughout. That is nothing but your Ts minus Tm. Okay. Now let us equate both the equations. Let us take it equation number third. So equating equation number third and first, what I will have, let us see. Third and second. So equating equation third and second, what I will have, that will be equal to nothing but what, m dot cp. Let us take it here only. So this will become equal to how much, let us see. So hope you have seen this. So equation number multiply by Tm minus Ti, multiply by Tm minus Ti. That is what, my dear students, Tm minus Ti will be equal to H into D into X. So this will be Ts minus Tm. So can I calculate the mean temperature? So let us calculate the Tm, my dear students. So how I will get the Tm? Let us see. So from here I can easily calculate the Tm, which will be equal to, let us see. So this is Tm minus Ti, okay, H into Ts minus Tm, H into Ts minus Tm is constant, and this can be taken as your Qx, my dear students, as heat flux is constant, Qx. So this will be equal to nothing but H, that will be Q. Heat flux is constant, my dear students. Heat flux is constant multiplied by area, which is nothing but D into, and that will not be dx, that will be pi dx, my dear students. Pi d into x. Okay. So 2 dot into pi dx, my dear students. So let us calculate the mean temperature here. So this will become equal to how much? So hope you have understood this. What I have done is I have taken the heat flux multiplied by area. So as the area will increase in this direction, continuously we are supplying the heat flux, what will happen, the heat will also increase. As the area will increase, that will be equal to nothing but pi d x. So as x will increase, the heat transfer in this direction will also increase, my dear students. So that is 2 double dot pi d x. So Tm will be given by here, Tm minus Ti is equal to Q into pi d x, my dear students, divided by m dot Cp. So you can calculate easily the mean temperature of fluid pi dx divided by m dot Cp plus Ti, and this is something like equation of line, that is y is equal to mx plus c, my dear students. And let us see, this is the line, my dear students, this is the line, that's why this is a line, that is not a curve. And if some square is there, x square is there, this will be some parabolic curve then, okay. So from here only you can calculate the mean temperature. From this equation you can easily calculate the mean temperature, my dear students. And after calculation of the mean temperature, so you can easily calculate the heat transfer at any point. So from this equation, what we can analyze, let us see, my dear students. So as heat flux is increasing, that Tm is also increasing. So as heat flux is increasing in x direction, the mean temperature is also increasing. And as shown in the figure. So hope this concept is clear, and this is much important for a grade point of view, my dear students. That is important for your grade. So remember all the concepts and you will do and enjoy all the questions, my dear students. That's my promise. Okay. Now, so this was up to it, my dear students. Thank you so much.